Data visualization is an important part of any analytics project, and that's no less true for quantitative textual analysis. In this video, we'll introduce a few of the more commonly used nodes to generate visualizations of text data within KNIME Analytics platform. Let's jump right into a workflow to see how these nodes work. Here in this meta node, I've pre-processed the IMDb movie review dataset to apply both parts of speech and sentiment tags to my text. There are a couple of different nodes you can use to review tags in your text. The first we'll examine is the Tag Document Viewer node from the KNIME Labs extension. In the node's configuration, we just need to tell it which document column we want to view, and make sure to check the Display Document Tags checkbox here. When we execute the node and open its view, we can see a colorful explosion of tags corresponding to the POS and sentiment tags applied earlier. This node is very useful for a quick review to make sure we've applied tags properly or to see if other pre-processing functions, like stemming or filtering, are included. Sometimes, though, we'd like to dive a bit more deeply into our text. For a more thorough overview, we can instead use the Document Viewer node. Now, what if we'd like to generate a visual summary of the contents of a large text collection? An easy way to do this is to use a word cloud, which will group together text where the size of each word corresponds to its frequency in a document or corpus. Word clouds may also implement color to highlight different classes that may appear in the text. Let's see how to use one. In this meta node, we've applied some typical text processing operations, such as filtering and stemming, and then transformed the text into a bag of words and calculated document frequencies. Having done that, we can feed the data into a tag cloud node to generate the visualization. You'll see that the node has several different available options, but let's focus on a few of the most important. First, note the tag column dropdown, where we select the words we want to plot. We can plot columns of both string or tag types. Here, I've chosen a column called term as string. Second, we choose a numeric column that will govern the size of the words that make up the cloud. In this case, we'll use the document frequency, which is the number of documents in our corpus that contain each term, but you could use any numeric measure that you like. Third, we'll want to consider the number of tags we want to display here, both to generate a cloud that's not too crowded, and also keep the runtime for the node reasonable. When we execute the node and examine its view, we see a cloud containing our stemmed terms, where both size as well as color correspond to the document frequency. That is, terms like movie, film, character, and watch show up often, which you might expect for a corpus consisting of movie reviews. In the top right corner of the view, we can make some changes on the fly to change what the cloud looks like. Options like the font scale, spiral type, and angle will be reflected right away, so we can easily find a visualization that is aesthetically pleasing. It's worth pointing out that visualization of text and documents doesn't always require a text-specific view. Sometimes a traditional view works just as well. In the configuration of this bar chart node, I can set up a plot of the top terms by document frequency by selecting an appropriate category column, aggregation method, and numeric column, in this case, DF. The executed view then gives us a more standard representation of document frequency, which we could perhaps incorporate with the tag cloud above in a combined view. To wrap up, here we've shown you a few different approaches for visualizing text data in documents. Whether you're trying to understand how your documents are tagged, you want to generate a tag cloud for a report, or you just need a more standard representation of text frequencies, KNIME Analytics Platform has nodes that can help you with the task.